The Enphase PowerPack Power Station is a sharp-looking, techie little power station from a really well-known residential solar company. But did they do a good job trying to enter the portable power game with this expensive unit, or should you guys spend your hard-earned money somewhere else? Spoiler alert, I would recommend that you actually... So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. We have had this little 1500 here at the lab for a little while now. We've put it through the test. We feel like we have a generally pretty good idea on it, and we are ready to share our experience with you guys. Given that Enphase has a specialty in monitoring, it has probably been spying on us the entire time through these top little sensors, but it is definitely the most certified unit that we have ever had here at the lab. As always, we will leave links in the description down below, as well as any coupon codes we can get from Enphase to save you guys some money if you're interested. Before we jump into our experience and all the things that we like and the things that we really don't like, we're gonna hit you with a super quick spec teardown to get you up to speed on the PowerPack 1500. First up, this thing passes the tiny baby lift test, but it weighs 55.7 pounds, which is pretty big for its size. It's got a 1,532 watt hour battery bank with an output of 1,500 watts on the inverter. In terms of getting power into this guy, you can charge it with a regular house outlet in your home in just about an hour, or it's got a 440 watt max solar input, which is kind of low. Taking a look at the ports on this guy, they're all underneath these little flaps. You have four USB-A's and two USB-C's, as well as a 12 volt car socket right here. You also have four 120 volt regular house outlets here underneath the flaps. They are jammed up really tightly together under there. And then on the back, you have your solar input, your AC wall plug input, as well as a barrel connector. I believe that barrel connector is 110 watt solar input. Looking at the screen and everything on the front though, it is a motion activated screen. It's honestly really nice, really clear, really bright, and it's color, which is cool. It does connect to an app. However, the app is one of the more useless apps that we have found. It's basically just for monitoring. Most apps let you go on there and change a bunch of settings that you can't do from the unit. This one basically just shows you what's happening with the unit. So if you're into monitoring, that's cool. You can control things like the fast charging, input current, and power saver settings, but you can also do that stuff for the most part right here from the screen. And when it comes to the price, at the time of filming this video, it is about $13.99 on sale, which is mildly expensive for what you're getting. Getting into some of the things that we really like about this Enphase PowerPack is that it is probably the most well-decorated power station that we've ever had here at the lab. Like we've said, it has a ton of UL certifications for a ton of different things, which makes sense from a brand like Enphase. They've been in the residential solar market forever, and they make some really good products over there. So it makes sense that when they came over here, they wanted to make sure that their stuff was top tier. It also might help justify the price on this thing if you care about things like UL certifications. For a power station, it's not always necessary. In my personal opinion, it doesn't matter too much to me, but if it matters to you, this thing has them. We also really like these charger flaps. Usually I'm not a fan of flaps that cover charger doors. I always complain about them because they're like dinky, little saggy, stupid, in the way most of the time. These ones, they actually seal really well. They have a nice seal gasket around the outside. They tell you what the plugs are rated for. So in this case, these USBs are 15 watts and these two over here are 60. This 12 volt car socket's rated for 120 watts. Really nice. They stay up and out of the way. And then when you let them go down, they just slam right into place, seal themselves up. Really nice. They're actually going to be water protective considering they have that gasket, which is cool. And all of them are like that. The ones on the front, the ones on the back, kind of unique, and I like it. We also really like the performance on this guy. They advertised that it was 82% efficient. 82.5% efficient. In our testing, it was actually 84. So that's cool to know that they're not lying about numbers on their unit. And then in terms of the rest of the performance on this guy, it actually did pretty well. The idle test was 21 watts when it's just on idling. So if you go ahead and you just turn on these AC plugs right here, they will use about 21 watts if you have nothing plugged in, just sitting here doing nothing, which means it'll last about 3 days on a charge if you forget to turn them off or if you have something plugged in that's finished charging or whatever. Not the best idle test numbers we've ever seen, but it's not terrible. And the fans were also really quiet. This is just another good power station that's nice and quiet. You can have it running near you in the same room as you. You're not gonna have to hear it. It's not distracting. It's actually not too bad. We also really like that the screen wakes on motion. The screen will dim when nothing is going on. And then as you walk up to it, it'll brighten up because there's probably a tiny little man that they stuffed in here behind there just waiting for you to walk in so you can flick on the light. But it is a nice feature as much as someone's in there spying on you the whole time. It is nice that when you approach it, it lights up for you so you don't have to do anything. It feels kind of nice. It's got that luxury vibe to it. And going off that point, the screen is also very nice. It's just a nice, simple touchscreen. It's in color, which is cool. It's clear, bright, easy to read. And overall, the unit kind of follows that trend. It's simple, it's sleek. It looks good. Like, it looks like a decent quality unit.
The silver bullet, dude.
The first thing that we don't love about the Enphase power station here is that the ports are very tight together. We found that it is slightly annoying. Like, they're first of all pretty deep. So something like a camera battery, like if you have a big brick camera battery charger like we do, it is kind of hard to get it to stay in here. And secondly, these plugs are really, really tight together. So if you have anything that overlaps the surface of one plug, you render the other one useless. So there's a ton of space on this power station, and somehow all four of the AC plugs are really, really, really tight together and very frustratingly hard to use all of them at once unless you're using a very simple extension cord type plug on every one of them. We also don't like that the solar input is really low compared to the battery size. 440 watts is just not great. A power station like the DJI Power 2000 has an 1800 watt solar input with a 2000 watt hour battery. So you could charge that thing in almost an hour with solar. This would take a long time to charge with just solar. It does have like a decorative light that you can turn on the bottom here, but it doesn't emit enough light to actually see anything. It's more for looks. It's not actually a light. It's like the unibrow on the Anker F3800. Nice, but not a light. We also find that the build quality, aside from looking pretty nice, is kind of low. And by that, I mean like these side plastics here are very, very thin. Like if you just press on them, you could feel there's nothing really in there. And this is for sure a unit that if I just dropped it off the edge of the table by mistake, if you were taking this anywhere and you had it on the tailgate of your truck and it fell off or anything, it would explode. Like it doesn't feel very durable or strong at all. So while the techie stuff is cool, the motion screen is kind of nice, I would love to see a standard screen and a unit that's gonna be a little bit more resilient over time. We also really don't like, I know a lot of you guys really won't like this either, when you set up the app with Enphase, you have to give them all of your information. Like literally almost every single piece of identity. They need your address, they need all of your information just to connect it to this thing. And aside from giving them all of your information, this unit has its own connectivity to a 4G network so that it can keep itself up to date and whatever they say. But I just don't like the way that feels. You have to give them all your information and then this is always connected to a network that you don't have any control over, at least no control that we know of.
I mean, I don't wear a tinfoil hat all the time, but I think I've got one on right now.
Yeah, I'm not like a scared person like that. This is the first time I've ever even said anything remotely like this. But I just don't like that you have to give them all your stuff and then they just track this thing wherever it goes. Like, what's going on with that?
Yeah, you're not buying an AirTag.
So at the end of the day, this isn't a bad power station, but in our opinion, it is overpriced for what you're getting. There's definitely better ways to spend this much money if you're trying to buy portable power. If you're not super set on name brand, you could get something like the Pecron E3600. It's basically double the battery capacity and inverter. And right now I think it's about $200 or so cheaper depending on what you find this guy listed at. If you do care about name brands, you could get something like the Anker F1500. Basically same size, same specs, but it comes from Anker and it's a couple hundred dollars cheaper as well. The main thing against this is really just the price. It just seems expensive for what you get. If you're getting an Enphase system put in on your house residentially and somehow this has worked into it, it's a great unit. I would still take it. But if you're still undecided, make sure you guys check out the description down below. We have a quiz you can take super quick. It'll spit out a recommendation that we recommend for you based on your needs when you do it. Otherwise, that's all we got for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.